Yes, and we're ready for the men's singles coming up. And onto court is Janu Jørgensen from Denmark. Born in 1987 in Aalborg in Denmark. And has been playing very steadily for the past 12 months or so, and up to number 3 on the world ranking. And here we got Chen Long from China, 187, a very tall athlete, and world ranked number 2 in the world, and has been that for a considerable time. So we are in for yet another thrilling match. And here we got the draw, and as you can see, we have Li Chongwei playing Kenichi Chago in the top half, and then this match in the bottom half. Chen Long against Jan Jorgensen. And we have the friendly hellos, toss of the coin. And I think it will be an interesting match, but also interesting from a different point of view, in the sense that Chen Long would, under normal circumstances, possibly beat Janu Jorgensen from Denmark. But I think if you look at recent forms, I think Jan was struggling in the beginning of January this year, having problems coming back from tournaments in December. Something really bothered him, perhaps malaria. Showed not to be. Then he had a thigh injury in Malaysia when he was playing the semi-final against Li Chongwei, and they've been struggling a little bit, but then recovered to form. But on the other hand, here what we've got, Chen Long, seeded 2, world ranking 2, he's been struggling lately. I think it really dented his confidence when he played the Thomas Cup in India just a few weeks back, when China was playing Japan in that semi-final, and Chen Long went on to play the first singles against Kenichi Chago, and he lost really big time. 2 straight games, very easy scores, and ever since he's not really played that well. So it will be interesting to see how it goes in this match. And the way to this semi-final for Chen Long, he beat Rumbaka from Indonesia 21-17, 21-11 in the first game. Had a very, very tough match against Sin Sumbunsuk from Thailand, 3 sets, and only winning 22-20 in that third and deciding, winning 2 straight games in the quarterfinal. And on to Janu Jorgensen here, seeded 3, world ranking 3. And his way to this semi-final has been somewhat easier. The first round he played Ueda from Japan, and winning in straight games 21-18, 21-14. In the second round, Latif of Malaysia, winning 21-18, 21-11. And yesterday against Soo Wan Ho from Korea, also 2 straight games, 17 and 14 in just 42 minutes. Here we got that confirmation. Best results for Janu Jorgensen is the 2010 Denmark Open winner, 2013 winner of the French Open, and he is the current European champion, which he just won a few months back, where he won the gold at the European Championship. On the other hand, we have Chen Long, and he has a very impressive run of results.
Get ready to play.
And obviously having an Olympic bronze medal from London 2012, All England 2013, China Open 13, Korea Open, All England this year. So it's been a very, very impressive record by Chen Long.
Thank you.
So, we're ready to begin. Yet another exciting match this
Ladies
afternoon.
Ladies and gentlemen, on my right, Chen Long, China. And on my left, Jan O. Jorgensen, Denmark. Chen Long to serve, love all, play.
Oh, what a wonderful shot. Well, this, if this is anything to go by, we will have another long, long, long match. And I can assure you that both of the players are physically very fit players and able to sustain for a very long time on court. When I mentioned earlier that Chen Long is suffering a little bit on the confidence side, I can tell you that in the Japan Open of just last week, he lost the quarterfinal to Hu Yun from Hong Kong. So he's got some work to do in this tournament, and I think he has done really well to get here, but man, he was struggling in that second round. Again, send some Bunsuk from Thailand. I was watching it on the sideline, and what a match it was. 23-25, then 21-16, and then the last one, 22-20. Variation from Yan on that click serve.
So the server, 3-0.
Now that's, if you are a Dane, it's very good to see. Because that is not one of Jan Ujørgensen's strongest points when he's playing that net. He can, on his good days, play really nice net play, but on his not so good days, that's definitely what's letting him down. But he's an attacking player, as what we saw here, and he loves that attack, and he's very, very explosive. And especially his follow-ups from the baseline towards the net is extremely fast. Chen Long, on the other hand, is a more steady player, plays with very good length on his shots, the lift from the net towards the baseline, his clears and all that. They're having a very good length. Physically strong, covering the court well, making it very difficult for his opponent. He's got to work hard. And I think a very good example of Chen Long's physically good abilities is the first tournament of this year, Korean Open, where he won, beating Lee Chong-wei. It's two straight games, 21-14, 21-15. But the thing was that the shuttles were so slow, I've been told, in Korea, and obviously suiting the game of Chen Long, the physical man. That's a good reply. Very good reply.
So the server, 5-7.
Well left.
6-7.
So just 1 point between the two players. That was a very, very fine example of a good lift from Chen Long. Possibly the trademark of Chen Long as well. We saw here that cross-court smash from the round-ahead position. One of his favorite shots. Proving to be the winner of this rally. And it's all square, 7-7. Yan has made that mistake. Similar situation, same shot. Two or three easy mistakes here from Yan.
8-9.
Oh, it's coming over, sorry. He was lucky. Apologize. I thought it wasn't going over. And suddenly all square again. Last time I think the two players played was in the Indian Open just a few months ago in the semi-final. And Chen Long won in three really, really tough games, losing the first one 21-15, but then winning 23-21, 21-19.
10-9.
Thank you. save by Chen Long. It's a very good follow-up.
So it's over.
Beautiful return.
Interval.
And is into the mid-game interval by the lead 11-10. And on court, the two coaches that used to play one another, Kenneth Jonasson from Denmark and Zhuangzi from China. They had some tough matches in their days and now are coaching these two top players. We've got Kenneth in the red, former world number two in singles. Very top player, very physical player, so he knows exactly what Yan is all about. We have that cross-court smash again. Good length on that lift. Yan was definitely in doubt. Yeah, but look at that follow-up from Yan. Seen it all the way. Again, sending strong signals to his opponent. Watch out, I'm there, I'm waiting for it. He was to the net, waiting for that shot. Beautiful net shot. One of the more difficult shots in the game of badminton. That forehand is definitely so much more difficult than playing that backhand, and look how beautifully that's done. Well played by Chen Long. Going long.
Robin Solver, 13-12.
Yeah, very nice to see. No dispute about changing shuttle. Chen Long wanted to change it, Yan changed it straight away. Really wonderful to see you not having these fights about shuttles. That's a good variation, but he was actually going out. Had it not hit Yan on the way, it would have gone out from that baseline. And I think that's what Yan is showing, that, you know, he wished he could get away from it. That one is coming there, that one there. I think Chen Long knows. Is the trademark of Yan Uyong's. That smash from the forehand side straight down the line and the follow-up is one of his absolute trademarks. Not many in the world can do as good as what he's doing there. That is an amazing shot. It was a straight winner. The way he is able to get the body behind it is unbelievable. obviously not so good on that short serve compared to the other shot we just saw before. It's going wide. Not a lot. The drift is sort of helping to keep it in, and it was just out. When I was watching it, it was going way out, but suddenly it stopped and falling just out that sideline. Jan is asking Coach Kenny Jonasson, is it in, is it out? But this doesn't really matter. He took it, played it, and that's what matters.
Thank you. Just ready. Play.
Things looked like they're a little bit going Chen Long's way. Good flick serve. Nice shot again by Jan. And look at that follow-up. Look at that. That is so explosive. Two other players in the world can do the same. Li Jiangwei and Lin Dan. But I think in this aspect of the game, Jan Jorgensen is way up there with the two guys. Two mascots cheering on the game. They're wonderful to watch. They really bring a smile to your face now and again. And Jan, he's really fired up. He's ready to rock and roll. 17 all. Good defense by Chen Long. Always making sure that his opponent is going to stay on court for a very long time to beat him. Good return of serve. Nice disguise. Pushing into a deep forehand corner. Chen Long off balance. Don't know if we get a chance to see it again, but that was a good return of serve. And here we've got the same smash again. Penetrating the defense of Jan Jorgensen on that backhand side. But it's very, very close to the line. Good angle, very steep, and virtually impossible for Jan to get back. So that was definitely a case of who dares wins. The drop shot played by Jan Jorgensen from such a low position was really a chance to take. But it paid off. Chen Long attacked the net, played it out on that baseline, and Jan has now earned his first game point of this match, 2019. Confirmation of this first game, 21-19, Jan Jorgensen winning this first game. Excellent play from both players, a joy to watch. And in just 20 minutes, and I say just when we consider all the other matches we've had today has been way longer than this, but 20 minutes so far in this first game. So that cross-court smash from Chen Long. Good attack by Jan here. See the coaches, they're really involved with their players. As I usually say, they laugh and they cry with their players, and that's the way it should be. Yeah, how tight that was. So close of going over. Jan did that on the previous shot, in the previous rally, and it got over. And here Chen Long was very unhappy and unlucky not to get that one over. So ready to start this second game.
Second game, level play.
Yeah, that's going long. Yeah, and I have to watch out for the drift.
So the server, 2-1.
It's not a lot, it's just a fraction. But obviously he's got to make a little bit of adjustment compared to the first game he played against the drift.
So the server, 2-0.
And from a tactical point of view, I think what could be good for Jan is what we just saw here, these flat exchanges. So far, he has won them all in the first game, and I think that's where he's got an advantage over Chen Long. Look at how high up he gets on that one. And what a beautiful, delicate drop shot. The smash, the follow-up. Chen Long completely caught, waiting for that push to the body. It's not coming, the drop shot is coming, and he can't get up to it. Good play by Chen Long. Really nice attack. Good to see. He's not just relying on his very good defense and physical abilities, but here he really goes on the attack. It's good tactics, good variation. Here we see world number two, really in action. Another good attacking rally here. Nice finish with a small disguise. He managed to push it down to that backhand corner. Coaches, which is obviously allowed as long as it's not during play. Good agility here. Chen Long almost passed Yan on that cross-court lift. Very attacking lift. Almost high enough to pass him. It's nice to see that Chen Long is putting my opening remarks to shame. The way he plays this semi-final in his Taurus and Iron, I think he's doing it very well. Doesn't show any sign of lack of confidence, just playing the game, and I think he's playing well. No, he's lost the first game here, but it was a nice, very nice first game. Good match, and very tight. And you have to consider is obviously world number two and three meeting one another, so anything can happen.
So the silver, 7-5.
After that baseline for him.
Six,
but the shot and the idea, the execution, everything just very nice and very perfect. We're talking about millimeters. The umpire urging Yan on to play. Well deserved, well played by Chen Long. First, the defensive shot was really good. This is the one here. That's very good. Totally stretching Yan. And then in trouble on that. Drop short as well. back to square. Eight all. And then Jorgensen in red, talking to his assistant coach. Ooh. That's very, very good of Yan to recover from that one and couldn't, unfortunately, control it. Played it long on the baseline, but imagine, you know, how hard you attack that net. And it's coming back and you still get back. Here it comes, and look at that. And then have to go all the way back and still get it. Unfortunately, not able to control it. Repeat of the previous rally. Once again, we saw that drop shot disguised so well. The attack at the net on that backhand side. Look at that. Look at how tight that is. Beautifully. Same as the first game. First game, 10 long, went into 11-10 lead. Interesting rally this. Janu Jorgensen is quite happy to defend it and is doing really well. And we see Chen Long in the attacking situation, but here the cross-court shot from Yan made the difference. And going into that mid-game interval, 11-10 up. Guess what will happen, but that's sport, that's what we like, that's why we're here watching it.
Service over, 11-all.
The players have to watch out for that cross-court smash. Here's the opponent getting it. And look at that, a little bit out of balance. Running that diagonal is a hard, hard work. Good aggression on that return of serve. What a smash. That was a devastating smash by Yan. Good defense. But here is a good shot. That net shot, that reply, changing the whole momentum of the rally. Good defense. Look at that. That's good play.
Play.
As earlier mentioned, it's sometimes a trouble spot for Yan. But today I think he's done really well at the net. So this is very excused for him. So far, it's been a good day in the office for the Dane. 14-12 up. Very nice disguise. He's out. Well left by Chen Long. But setting it up with that beautiful disguise on that drop shot. The drop shot, but he was standing very close to that net and the lift came. He's out. Thank you. on the play by Chen Long. That smash down the line is really good. We have just played 40 minutes in this men's singles. Where the opponents have to be very careful, pushing the body. That one there, Yan is so good at it. Got to watch out. Look at that. Very quick reactions. Good to see that Jan Jorgensen is stepping into the shoes of Peter Gade for Danish badminton, really up there in the top three, playing very good badminton. And it started all back last year, 2013, where Jan suddenly steadied his game dramatically, and it took him high on the ranking, and he stayed at the number three spot now for several months. That's in. Victory for Jan Jorgensen. Nice net play here, 19-16. Two points away from victory. Beautiful net shot. Some of the pressures on Chen Long. Got to find some answers. And there's an answer, that's a definite answer. Pushing Jan around on the defense. Jan had to lift eventually, and that cross-court smash came into action again. Really heating up here. Drop shot. Oh! A very good chance by Chen Long. I think he did all the right things. But the reply from Jan Jorgensen here was just simply too good. That drop shot, under pressure, tremendous pressure. He could see Chen Long coming in, covering the net, and still he played such a good shot and got match point 20-17 off. Three match points here. And he's going for all-out attack. And we have a challenge. The smash is called in by the linesman. I personally think it's in as well, but Jan has taken the chance. He's got two challenges in this match, and why not use this one? Imagine winning on a challenge and taking him into that final of the Indonesian Open. Here it comes, but it's, as I say and said, it's well in. Plum on the line. So Chen Long still have to save another two just to square this one. The crowd is going mad. Played by Janu Jorgensen. Congratulations from the two coaches. Lars Ulrich, Kenneth Jonasson. And what a win for Jan Jorgensen. Throwing shirt and sweatband and everything to the crowds, thanking the service judge. And well deserved, what a good match. We just witnessed by Jan Jorgensen here, we got the match point. And the players are escorted out of the court by the officials while we're here seeing some of the highlights. And that was a good rally by Jan. Seen that, saw that on a few occasions. Good to see Chen Long here on the attack. Maybe something he should have used some more. And another fine example. Same shot, same situation. Attack by Jan, place right at the right hip, and this is good, that's very quick, and now the smash is coming cross court. And match point, I don't think he can believe it. And here we got the schedule of the day. The first four matches concluded. And the next one coming up is men's doubles, where we have Mohammed Hassan and his partner Hindra Setiawan up against Kim and Kim from Korea. the Estoros and I in Jakarta, waiting for the men's doubles to come up. Mohamed Hassan, Hendra Setiawan of Indonesia, home ground defending champions, up against the number four seed, Kim Ki-jung and Kim Sa-rang of Korea. The crowd is going mad. Everything is going mad in this stadium.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the
court. We will see the players coming very, very soon.